Hi, and welcome to Encore Radio. On today's episode of Encore Meets, we're backstage at Wicked with the very glamorous Nikki Bentley. Welcome.
Thank you.
So, what keeps you going through a show?
Lots of water, lots of baroccas. I've got shares in boots, as you can probably see. I try not to do too many weird things because I think sometimes rituals, and they become a thing rather than actually them doing anything for you.
Yeah.
Water is the power of life, I always say, as long as you're hydrated. We have a very dry stage here, so I have my funky little nebulizer, which I think quite a lot of people, I always think these look really stagey. But basically it just puts and you just inhale it and it just puts moisture in the back of your throat, which helps with the dryness. But and that's pretty much all I do, is water and a bit of nebulizer, that's it. And a barocca before the show, without fail.
What do you think keeps bringing audiences in to Wicked?
Well, I think, first of all, the visual is, you know, the costumes, the staging, the props, the scenery is just, you know, and I think it fits so well in this theatre as well.
Yeah.
You know, so visually, it's just a spectacle. I think it's the story because it's a story of friendship, it's a story of love, it's a story of acceptance. And I think that kind of story is always relevant,
yeah.
And especially nowadays, you know. And so I think, and so there's always a character, and I think very much always Elphaba and Glinda, they are so relatable. Everyone, I don't think I've ever known, even people that don't sort of necessarily love theatre,
yeah.
I don't think anyone's ever come to see the show and gone, meh. I just don't think you can.
There is something for everyone.
Absolutely. And I just think the story of acceptance and friendship and love is so strong. And that's what makes it such a beautiful piece. And and the script as well, it's so well written. And the songs speak for themselves. They are just out of this world.
At the end of time I see it, there's always something that I notice. Like I've seen the show five times.
That's the thing. There's so many different things going on. And that's one thing I love about in rehearsals. They say to all the Shiz students, they're like, you're not just background people.
Yeah.
You know, these scenes.
We're not fillers.
No, these scenes would not work without each individual person's reactions. And like you said, I mean, I think my parents have seen the show. Don't even know how many, and they always say that same thing. Oh, I noticed this today. Yeah. I noticed this.
And especially when you speak about the book and the script, the elements of Last Mile sort of like propaganda that you didn't really think about before.
Yeah.
You'd be like, oh, that's a bit relevant.
Yeah.
Obviously, of course, it's relevant now. But
absolutely. Yeah. And I just think, I just think it's so relatable with so many people, and it touches here.
Yeah.
I think, and that's what keeps bringing people back. And I think.
When was the first time you saw the show?
So I saw it back in, when Adina was doing it, so when it just opened. So when was that, 2006,
yes,
I want to say? Yeah. And I was sat, I think, row F, I think.
And I love stories like this.
I know.
Have you sat back in that seat
I mean, probably, but I would have done.
You should do now.
Oh,
now you're in the
goodness,
role, be like,
yeah.
This is where I sat,
yeah. And I will never forget, it was when I just started college. It was my first year at college. And
Where did you train?
At Performers College in Essex.
Yeah, lovely.
And I remember it being played around the college, and I was like, what is this? I like this. And then everyone sort of got on board with it, and I was like, I need to see the show. And I remember coming, I went with one of my best friends at the time and my parents to come see the show, and it was everything I wanted it to be and more. I mean, the end of Act One is always going to be one of those moments in theatre that is just out of this world. And I just cried the whole way through and just knew that that's what I wanted to do. And like I said, that's a role I'd like to play, you know. But it really came from here. There was something, I was like, that's me. That's me.
And that's why I think you've got the role, because you listen to every other Elphaba story, and it's that time where sitting in the auditorium, and Rachel Tucker said when she saw the show on Broadway, she was inconsolable.
Yeah.
She was like, it's not the fact that I would like a turn at that.
No.
I actually have to do that, otherwise
absolutely.
I will kill someone.
And I think you have to have that level of passion for the role to do it, because it does take a lot, because it's such a demanding role, and you know, and it's... So you have to have that behind it, to, you know, and that's what, again, that's what makes Elphaba so special as a character. She's so well written, and she's just awesome.
She is.
She is.
As an actress, do you have a favourite moment in the show?
I really love the Wizard's Palace into Defying Gravity. That sounds so cliche because it is such a huge moment, but it is such a turning point for Elphaba, because she goes from, you know, being so, the wizard, every, you know, he's gonna make me normal, I'm gonna have normal skin, I'm gonna, you know, he's gonna change my life, you know, and then she finds out that he's kind of basically a fraud. And you know, and then you see it happen, you know, and that's your job as an actress, to then show, and it's hard when these people are hundreds of miles away, it feels sometimes, you know, to show that thought process of, no, I don't know what this feeling is that I'm having, you know, and that's the whole thing, you know, with the verses in the beginning of Defying Gravity, is that something's happening inside her that's telling her, this is the journey I need to go on, this is now my purpose. I don't know what's going to happen, but I'm just going to go with it. Mm. And as much, you know, and that's a really powerful moment to play, to go from this vulnerable girl that's just, you know, has all these hopes and dreams, to I now know what my purpose in life is, to, you know, and it's scary because it's gonna, you know, potentially turn everyone against me. Yeah. But again, it just, and I love that, it's the bravery. That's what I love. That's another thing, going back to your question earlier, is the bravery. She's so brave and courageous. And I absolutely adore that about her. And then obviously Defying Gravity is such a moment in, you know, I don't think there's anyone that can say they don't like that moment in, you know.
No. It's a musical theatre landmark.
Absolutely, absolutely.
And for people who are watching this video who are interested in musical theatre, and we have people of all ages watching these videos, what advice do you have for people who want to get into the industry or take a chance?
I would say, go for it. And that's another thing that this, you know, this story tells you is, you know, don't ever let anyone tell you that you can't do something. Mm-hmm. Because there have been people that told me I was never ever going to do this. It was stupid. Well, who's laughing now?
Nikki's Elphaba dreams come true.
Yeah. I would say, you know, get yourselves to, you know, a lot of people can go to dance classes and singing classes. Stage coach is always a good thing, mm-hmm. Like some sort of Sunday stage schools. And if it's, you know, that kind of gives you a feel for it. And then if it's something that you really do feel that you want to pursue, performing arts colleges are always the best way, sort of 3-year, 2-year courses, just because they, you know, you need to learn that discipline, and it's such a cutthroat business, you know, and they teach you everything that you need to learn. I would say, and just always believe in yourself, which is such a hard thing. I mean, even as professionals now, I've been in the business for over 10 years, and you still have days where you go, No, I can't do it. You know, and no one on that panel when you're auditioning is going to believe in you unless you believe in yourself. And it does take, and that is the hardest thing, but that's the best bit of advice I could give anyone, is always believe in yourself. Take a breath, believe in yourself, and just, because the panel always want you to do well. That's the interest. That, and when you go in and you think, oh no, they hate me, they want you to do well because it makes their job easier. Yeah. But I would say, don't ever let anyone tell you that you can't do something. If that's what you want to do, go for it.
And a perfect place to finish. Thank you so much for taking time to speak to us.
No, thank you for having me.
And we'll leave it there. Thanks, guys.